Using still images in your video usually sucks, let's be honest. They're flat, they're boring, and no matter what you do, everyone can tell they're just pictures. Sure, we've all tried the usual fix. Punch in, keyframe a slow move, and pretend that it makes it exciting. And before keyframes even existed, filmmakers used their rostrum cameras to do this manually. One filmmaker, Kenneth Lauren Burns, used this technique so much that the effect literally got named after him, the Ken Burns effect. You've probably seen it in Final Cut Pro. But even with that subtle movement, it still looks like a picture sliding around on screen. No depth, no realism, just a photo. But what if you could take a still image and make it look like a real 3D scene with actual depth and lifelike camera movement? Well, now you can. Today, we're taking a look at a plugin that makes using still images in your videos not boring. It's called Deep Pan from O-Motion, and the best part is it's completely free. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Deep Pan plugin made by O-Motion. This plugin uses AI-generated depth maps to add a lifelike sense of depth to your still images. It's basically the Ken Burns effect on steroids. Let's take a look. The Deep Pan plugin is available through FXFactory, and like I mentioned earlier, it's completely free. It runs in Final Cut Pro, Motion, Premiere Pro, and After Effects. If you've installed plugins from FXFactory before, you probably already have their app on your Mac. If not, it's a free download. Installing Deep Pan in Final Cut Pro is simple. Open the FXFactory app, and if you don't see it featured on the main page, type Deep Pan into the search bar. Hit the download button, and FXFactory will handle the install. If Final Cut Pro is open, close it first. That's it. Next time you open Final Cut Pro, you'll find Deep Pan in the effects browser. Before you add the effect to your still image, there are a couple things you'll want to do first to get the best results. Most photos come in a 4:3 aspect ratio, which doesn't match a typical 16:9 project. So start by cropping or resizing your image to fit your timeline. You can either scale it manually or change the spatial conform to fill. Next, reframe your shot and lock in your final composition. This part's important because of the way Final Cut Pro handles effects. Once you apply Deep Pan, you won't be able to adjust framing afterward. And finally, turn your reframed image into a compound clip. Just select it and hit Command G. With that done, grab the Deep Pan effect from the effects browser and drag it onto your compound clip. Once the effect is applied, even the default settings look way better than a basic Ken Burns move. But Deep Pan also gives you quite a few settings you can adjust to take it even further. The first setting you'll see is a depth map source. Most of the time, you'll use a generate in live mode, where the plugin produces a fresh depth map for every frame right in Final Cut Pro. It's quick, automatic, and usually gives you great results. If you want the best performance, especially on older machines, you can switch to the second option and save the depth map to your hard drive and use it from there. You can even bring in depth maps made in other software and use them with Deep Pan. But for most people, generate in live mode will still be the easiest way to go. You can also take a closer look at the depth map by clicking on the preview checkbox. This gives you a clear visual of how Deep Pan handles your image. There's also a feather slider that softens the edges of the map. I like to leave this at the default setting, and if the final result has any distortion, I adjust the feather just enough to clean it up. Next is progress mode. By default, this is set to auto, which automatically adjusts the motion so it fits the length of your clip. You can also switch to looping mode if you want the movement to repeat, and you can change how often the loop happens. Or if you want full control, choose the first option and set the motion yourself using keyframes. For this example, I'll leave it in auto. Next, we have easing options. Instead of just a basic linear setting you get in Final Cut Pro, Deep Pan includes 14 different easing styles. This makes your motion feel a lot more natural, whether you want a smooth start, a softer stop, or something more stylized. Honestly, I really wish Final Cut Pro offered this many easing choices when animating with keyframes. Under the easing options, we have points A and B, and zoom settings also apply to this part. I like adjusting these using the on-screen controls in the viewer window. Points A and B control the direction and amplitude of your animation. Point A is your start, and point B is your end. The zoom control point sets the center of the zoom motion. Back over in the inspector window, you can also adjust the amount of zoom with the zoom slider, and the depth of your image with a displacement slider. Don't get carried away here. 5 to 10% is the recommended amount. Go higher than that, and you'll start to see distortion in your image. And last, we have the shake sliders. These add a bit of camera shake to your animation, giving it a more dynamic feel. Same as the displacement slider. A little goes a long way here. Deepan is great for landscape images, but you can also use it for close-up shots. You just need to tweak the settings a little bit more. Let's add some motion to the next image. Just like before, reframe your image so it fills the video frame and make it into a compound clip. With the default settings, if we skim through the clip, you'll notice some distortion on the subject, especially around her arm. When you're animating a close-up shot, make sure points A and B are both placed over your subject. This helps reduce distortion right away. You can also bring the displacement amount down a bit and raise the feather slider to clean up any remaining areas. Add a small amount of camera shake, and just like that, your plain still image looks way more dynamic. And that's Deepan. It's honestly one of the most impressive tools you can use to add life to your still images. And the best part is it's completely free from FXFactory. No strings attached, no trials, nothing. Just download it, drop it into your timeline, and you're good to go. I'll leave a link down below so you can grab it for yourself. If you found this helpful, hit the like button and consider subscribing. I'm pushing hard towards 100,000 subscribers, and every sub gets me one step closer. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.